boy, does this movie have a lot to prove. James Cameron's legacy on the ropes, and it certainly doesn't help that he keeps trash-talking superhero movies. Tim Miller kicked off the franchise he helped establish. Arnold Schwarzenegger, he hasn't had a genuine hit since the last time he worked with Cameron, and that was True Lies back in 1994. Side note, why is True Lies not available anywhere to rent or purchase? I wants to see it again! And then, it would seem that after the last few movies, it's the Terminator franchise itself that has a dark fate. Will the return of Linda Hamilton be wasted? Let's take a look. It's a pretty darn good package, but we've been fooled so many times before by this franchise. All right, here we go. Oh, it's so long.
2 days ago, I had this nice, simple life. And now it's a nightmare.
If travel is searching, very Logan-y at the moment. That's one of the Terminators. I don't know what that is, but it's cool. Oh, wow. Ooh. Oh. That CGI looks poor. Ooh, I like that Terminator design. That's really cool. Ah, I've missed you, Linda. Apparently she hasn't fought a Terminator in a while, though.
Who are you?
My name is Sarah Connor. Never seen one like you before. Almost human.
I am human.
Ooh.
Why do you care what happens to her?
Because I was her.
A retired Terminator?
How do we win?
We win by keeping you alive.
I'm going hunting.
You know, I would sit Tim Miller down and I would say, "Why do you think I hired you, Tim? It wasn't for your storytelling skills. Where are my video game level action sequences?" I mean, look, never underestimate James Cameron. He's very good at heart. It's what always makes, it gives his movies that extra oomph, both with moviegoers and at the box office. But you know, Alita, fun movie, you know, very, you know, I wouldn't say a very strong movie, but it was very good. I see similarities actually between this and Alita. Maybe James Cameron ain't so good a producer. Maybe he needs to actually be in the behind the camera himself. And so it's very similar, in fact, I think, to Alita. But the scale seems much smaller than one would hope. And when you ask someone what they think about Terminator, I would think the dum-dum-dum, you know, like whatever, you know, that great cool sound is, especially from, you know, from T2, would be what people think of. And the blue tones, you know, this is just kind of like Terminator meets Logan. And I already saw Logan. So I'm intrigued by the changes to the mythology, especially because James Cameron was involved in them. So I'm curious as to what these different Terminators are. I like that, you know, you basically have a T-1000 and a T-800 melded together. You know, basically one's wearing the other. So you have, it's almost like Russian nesting dolls, which is a really interesting idea. They can work together in tandem. That's kind of a cool idea. But, you know, and also, you know, I just feel like they haven't given these actors don't seem to have, like, just too many other actors as well. Like, you're not really giving them an opportunity to be able to establish themselves. You know, it's, you know, and good luck competing with Linda Hamilton and Arnold Schwarzenegger. But I think that the trailer just wasn't strong enough out of the gate, I think, to change a lot of people's minds. But we'll see how the actual movie fares. What do you think? What do you, does it pique your curiosity at all? I took a poll last night, and most of you say you just simply weren't interested in this movie. And I bet this isn't enough to change a lot of your minds. All right, share your thoughts down below. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.